Hello and welcome back to the Hacknet. This is our episode number 4. We are going to continue our hacking adventures, and as it is usual, we will start with our own shell and opening a trap so that we can protect our own computer or server or whatever. Diving sparrow. Oh yeah, we were reading some stuff. It was this one. I am writing this in faith that I told you this password, that you are the person I hope you are, and because it's all I have to work with right now. Thank you for looking so far. It seems a lot to ask for that. Anyone will read it. It seems a lot to ask for that anyone will read this, but I guess I'm doing a lot of that lately. To business then. If you are actually here then, well, that's already my worst case, and I have some hard requests to me. You must have run into the files on what NTAC's up to, and I hope you feel the way I do about it. You've seen how good NSEC is already, incredibly so. And once it's polished up, I wonder how much of the freedom we have now will slip away. This is maybe actually fine. I am fine with that, and on a lot of levels I respect them trying to fix security and want it to work, even if it cripples what I am best at. But not like this. The Hacknet project is the problem. It's great to make good security, it's even kind of okay to hold a lot of control over it and its usage, but breaking everything except what you've made isn't. Before I knew it, I'd contributed too much to Hacknet. It was an incredible project, fun and challenging, and they just threw resources at it endlessly. Amazing to work on. And I made something incredible. It is called Port Hack. Basically, a sum of my knowledge and skill, it opens doors just about anywhere. I got curious after a while and broke in to the mainframe and put it all together. Maybe the first complete build that had been done of the project with a complete port hack wired in. It's not so hard to see what happens from here. They complete this. Hacknet gets out somehow, the world's in total chaos, and our one chance to stop digital security from falling into this insane monopoly slips away. What we have isn't perfect, and NTAC's security is good, but Hacknet ruins everything. And if we don't stop it now, it might be too late to stop it ever. The CEO's email account tells the rest. rc@ntech.com. With the password of by C89K W capital M E. Their server, mail server, was this one, right? Login RC. Password is YC89KWME. A former employee's gone rogue and is threatening the project. Unlike most, I'm actually concerned that he knows what he's doing and could be a real problem. As much as I hate being so crude about it, this project is too important to me and to the world to put it at risk of something like this. Can you discourage him? Details are attached. Call him Bit. charged to your account as per normal. Good to have you on board. What exactly are your plans this time? He's important and well informed. I've put out the order, expensive, but he will be dead within the week. Dad, what the hell are you talking about? I wanted you to smash up his computers and arrest the guy, not kill him. Call this off right now, this has gone far enough. I'll deal with it myself. The man's a genius, even if he's against the project, I want him around. Find a way to stop it, for God's sake. If you are serious about this, I'm holding you personally responsible. Don't with me here. It's too late, can't stop it. It's anonymous. You need to be clear about wording if you want specific action taken. Payment will proceed as promised, or my employees may take issue with their client. It's not too late if he's not dead yet. Call this off right now. I'm revoking payment. This isn't what I hired you for. Personal value to the project side. I'm not going to be a goddamn accessory to murder because of your stupid misunderstanding. The target is deceased. What have you done? This isn't what I wanted. This isn't what I wanted, you psychopath. Payment has been received and our business is concluded. Something's come up. I need access to the mainframe to have a look around. I'll be investigating recent accesses and builds, so I need admin. Sure thing. Mainframe access emergency. V193288HQ9. If I'm the CEO, can I read someone else's stuff? I cannot. Alrighty then. But I found some mainframe account. Is it Prometheus? Is it... Maybe was it Zeus? It was Zeus. Well, I have quite a lot of stuff here. But I think I'm getting ahead of myself. Because perhaps contact me once you've caught up and let's finish this. Termination. You've read it too, you know what this means. At the very least, I'm starting with doing whatever I can to finish what Beat started, if this is how it ended. Well, you found a way into the contract server. I was digging around for their backups. They store them offline, but the server auto-connect to the net at set intervals to pull updates down from production servers so they stay up to date. With some clever patch pushing, I think I can get it up. Getting you a connection isn't simple, but I have a plan. I've re-rigged one of my old sequencing programs to time it all for you. It's something I used to use to coordinate takedowns and the like when working with friends. There is an imported copy on the CSAC asset server called Sequencer. Run it when you are ready. It'll signal me to bring the backup server up and pipe a connection through to you. You won't have long, but it should be enough. While I keep it online, get to their backup and wipe out everything with the word Hacknet in it. I'll keep it up, and while you are there, I'll wipe the mainframe. So what's going on as soon as I do this? There is supposed to be like some super hacking stuff, right? Are we going to auto-connect to someone? To their backups, right? Oh, and I need a proxy for that. And to deal with all their servers. So, to deal with all of their ports. Emmet Place. The hell? Okay. Yeah, it will take some time. Half of my time waits to just goes on to deal with the Yeah, I'm not sure I will be able to finish it in time, by the way. No. I mean, it's just too close. Well, yeah. So this happens. Oh, and it's already open? What? Oh, seriously? People, this time you make it just too easy. At least I have time to have a look at it. And I also fork bump them, so just to be sure, you know. And so it ends. As revenge, it's shallow to me. Just lashing out at what he was and all too late to help him at all. But this felt right. I guess I should be more used to it. No one will notice, huh? Not except the ones who be in a rage over the loss. No one's going to be thanking us no matter how much damage it might have caused otherwise. Such is the way of things, I guess. You helped a lot and I'm grateful. There is only so much I can do with this veil of anonymity kept on, and after that, seems like a terrible time to shed it. So I'll see you back at CSAC. There is always chaos there, and I'll find a way to pay you back soon enough. Hey, I'm not sure if it's sensible to be writing this one first. If all's gone to plan, this should be basically the last you hear from me. Maybe the last anyone hears from me, but hey, this one's optimistic. If this ever gets sent to you, that's the best news I could hope for. So thank you. I can't imagine it'll be easy. Will have been easy? This tense is going to take some getting used to. There is still one last thing I want to ask of you. Not that I haven't asked way too much already. Port hack's not quite a standalone thing. It was once, but, well, you can probably understand now why this can't exist as something people just pass around. Its core, heart, is the last piece left. It's built to be untemperable, but I've done what I can. This is my last request. Or of far too many. What am I supposed to do with this thing? Now let's go fork bomb this stuff. But first, where is my blue one? Ah, thank you. The hell are you? Seems like a trap. Okay, fade to black. And observe some stuff. Does it kind of remove itself? And now my server supposedly also removes itself.
Hi. My name's Bit, and if you're hearing this, I'm already dead. It also means Port Hack Heart stopped, and my scripts worked. Which means we're finished. Which means you've done it. doing this now was our last chance, I think. While they're in a rush to finish it all, and not under the eyes of the whole world yet. So, thanks. Thanks. If all's gone right, there's just one copy of Hacknet left to delete. And you're looking at it.
This is an interesting poking at the fourth wall. Like, literally, I have this piece of software called Hacknet. Did I really hack somebody's PC and server? Nah. I expect titles to be in order right now. This is not something I can skip. I don't expect them to be too big though. Ethan Flippity Jibida. Okay. And we've had quite a lot of testers, I see. So there are two things that we can do right now. First, I hope we can pop back to the game shortly before we finished it to start Kagwa trials. And the other thing that we have is the labyrinth. I'm not sure if those are two different things or it's the same, but we'll check it out right now. That's not a big issue. So yeah, we get back here. What do we have? Congratulations, you've just completed Hacknet. This started as a side project in a 48-hour game jam between friends, and people liked it so much that I worked on it casually for a while to produce a prototype version in 2012. The response was amazing, and though I ended that version with an email saying I was stopping working on the game for other projects, I couldn't stay away. I kept working on it and it pretty quietly behind the scenes, and eventually 2.5 years later it became what you just finished. Thanks for playing. If you like the game, send me an email and let me know what you think. If you're interested in following more stuff I make or want to bug me to work more on this or things like it, you can follow me on Twitter. The linked computer has a few secrets from the game. Take a look. Music changer. Is it something like admin? Shit. Blizzard updater. credits, congratulations, hidden stuff. There are a few not so well hidden tricks in the game that are essentially leftovers of extra features from development that aren't directly part of the main game. The CD tray. Yeah, the fork bomb. Security tracer, name generations. Name of computers and companies in Hacknet are procedurally generated from a list of possible main names and postfixes. Every time you play, it'll be different. The servers in the game, like the email server, are internally consistent servers with procedurally generated accounts and emails. Try hacking the email server you connect to all the time and check it out. See if you can decipher the storage format of emails and how my parser works. Secret path. There is a big secret path in Hacknet that's essentially a third faction. If you're looking for more, try playing again and being more aggressive. Look more closely for secrets, especially at how things happened, how things got where they did and where they came from. All people and hackers can be traced and investigated if you look hard enough. Thanks again. If you decide to play again, there is a server you can access from the start of the game with all the port exploits on it that you can access at 1337. Cheaters stash. Wallpapers. Well, I don't see any Blizzard thing. But let's go check out Cheater's Stash. I see nothing interesting in here as well. So now, as I told you, what we can do, we can go back to the CSAC and we have Kagwa Trials here. This task represents the start of what CSAC admins predict to be an unusually long sequence. If you have critical business, we recommend completing that before progressing with this task. An agent known as Kagwa has posted a link to an unusual set of trials as a requirement effort for some sort of team. The message implies agents will be well rewarded in exchange for helping with some work for this team if they happen to pass the tests. The task is non-critical to CSAC and is presented as an opt-in task for anyone interested. Abort current contract? Which one is my current one? Yeah, Hacknet Labyrinths, I am aware of that. I have a feeling like I don't have any active contract. I have no idea what this was all about, so... Someone named Kagwa has sent out a recruitment challenge to several prominent groups, one of which was CSAC. It looks fairly sophisticated and extremely well organized. We suspect that whatever's behind those trials is going to be a significant time investment, possibly taking whoever completes it away from CSAC for a while, so know that before heading in. That being said, you are of course free to investigate whatever you want, and this seems like a promising lead if you are after new tools. The instructions in the challenge provide an IP address attached below and instructions to begin the trials. First, I am going though to clear out my notes. And then we're gonna have a look at this Kagwa source. So I don't see anything being connected in the network. I don't see any EOS devices as well. Kagwa trials. I'll take that. I'll take that as well. And I will take whatever that is. Kenobi. Recruitment. I'm Kagwa, and I'm forming a team. Elites only, all resources shared, building towards big things. Interested applicants can apply via the executable here. Running this program constitutes an agreement to be tested and an understanding that you may be found unworthy. But some things are in order. First, FTP XA becomes FTP bounce XA, and FTP sprint becomes just FTP. Next, we have, what was it? It was Kagwa Trials, right? Right. We also have Kenobi. Headers. Only hope. Source IP. Yeah. What if I try to decipher? This Kenobi thing. With only hope. But this one is incorrect. Well. Let's start our trial then. Damn, I love those tiny animations. Okay, apparently I'm being either hacked or whatnot. Congratulations on completing the first test. Your second begins now. Welcome to the trials. Connect to IP address, download any tools you find, and delete all system files we will be watching. Good luck. I wonder if I can kill the Kagwa trial. That would be interesting, but I will not do this. 74.1.25, 23.1.21. Kagwa sprint trial. Have SSH and FTP. But because it's FTP sprint, it now works much, much faster. Now I do have quite a while. Hey, why did you close my own shell? Well done. Next. IP address. Adapt. Advance. Kagwa push trial. 6.8.8.1 FTP 21. So those two are just enough for me. Yeah, the torrent thing though. It will be closed, right? I mean, it says delete me. Congratulations, trial is complete. Forwarding connection. As far as the trials go, I wouldn't say it was too difficult. But perhaps this is like the idea, you know? Hey, nice work! You're the third one through! I'm connecting you to our home base now. Hold on. Oh yeah, and I do have a head start, given the fact that I'm operating the Hacknet OS, you know? Connected to bibliothèque. Man, the spin down time on torrent stream injector is so damn annoying. The port is saturated just fine after a few seconds, but it hangs around forever. Makes me want to decompile it, but I bet it's a mess in there. It's not really a problem, is it? It kinda slows me down and it's annoying. How is that not a problem? Kill the process when it's done. What do you want? What's the problem? I actually never even thought of that. Don't mind me. Announcement. User added to the whitelist. I'd like to welcome me to the fold. Congratulations on beating the trials. The others are out on assignments right now. There should be time for you to catch up if you want in on this round. You're on the team now, so the final contract belongs to you. Contracts are on a first-come, first-served system here. I mostly take care of admin, recon, and all that, making sure everyone has stuff to do that builds towards our goals and everyone has all the tools and info they need to do their work. Introduce yourselves when you've got a sec. In the meantime, check out the server and take a look at that last job. Welcome to the team. Hey ho, guys. Ho ho. I have received word on the location of someone who's been developing a means of breaking through SSL ports. Unfortunately, their security setup is a bit unusual. The target seems customization obsessed, a ricer, and has security to match. Non-standard configs, ports, and service allocations are all over the place. Once you've found a way in, we want a copy of the latest SSL breaker software. It might be encrypted or secured somehow, but that's fine. upload it to our drop server, which is linked, once you've got something, and we'll take care of getting it up and running. So we have a drop server where we should deliver stuff. We have the dude's PC, and we need to find this SSL thingy. Access denied. Well, this is impressive. But not that impressive. Whoever owns this system does not even have any kind of active security in place, which is like, why? Theme changer. I should have it. Work in progress. And okay, we have both of them. So I want to take the work in progress and this one as well. We have themes, and basically this is it. Let's first start with the work in progress and see what we can get out of it. Can I decipher it? I can. But I would expect this one to be password locked, which is not the case, apparently. Okay. Can we move SSL Trojan to bin SSL XA? Oh, you probably use one of the open ports. Yeah, okay. Makes sense. Upload binary. Is it just because I renamed it? connect and bypass, look for the latest version, upload. But I mean, I did upload it, right? Decryption setup complete. Unfortunately, it's not that portable yet. I'll get to work building a new shareable executable for it, but for now just run stuff past me and I'll take a look. I wonder how long it'll take until you've spent more time decrypting stuff for us than it'd have taken you to set this up properly. Okay, yes, I'm ashamed of myself, but no, I'm not answering that. It works. It'll be better when I've got time. I'm sure we can all live with that for now. Alright, I'm looking at this SSL stuff, getting it decrypted and packed into something convenient. It actually looks like most of this is already done for me here. I've seen this Trojan style before. It's a bit untested, but this build is usable if you want to rush into it. I've uploaded it to the drop server. So basically the program tunnels through an already opened port to hijack the SSL one. So you need to provide it not only the SSL port number, but also a flag to say which port you want to tunnel through and that's port number. Current flags are SSH, HTTP and FTP. So those are uploads. This is SSL Trojan, but I believe I have that. New toys, read above. DDoSer on some critical services. Coil dug up the source of some of the Grindcraft server outages we wanted stopped. Someone apparently thinks it's hilarious to try DDoSing the secrets of Grindcraft servers, like they're not under enough load with the entire world hammering them to get the new update. Anyway, Coil has keeping them up as one of her conditions for joining the group, so we want this disturbance fixed. They're probably using the LOIC low orbit Ion Cannon code for it, so I'll settle for just wiping that folder and stopping it. But if you want to do a little damage in Sys, no one's going to judge you. Keep in mind that you should probably do a quick look and scan for anything else you can find there and make sure you get everything. So yeah. This SSL thing is really trippy though. I do love it though. Al Schefer's netbook. So we have sources. targets and the guide. With that out of the way, we are going to this netbook. We are going to have a look at this one. Scan is complete. Smugshop.txt. This guy, he thinks he's so incredible in the most basic way. He's just like the vanilla flavor you get from the smug shop. The people behind the counter are like, sure, you don't want anything else, some toppings or another flavor or something. He's all like, nah, I just want the brain pre-2009 candy package. Some IP addresses. Oh, the dudes are still going to school, right? Alrighty. Could have fork bombed his computer as well, but I'm not cruel. Channel update. Excellent work on your recent tasks. It's time for a team project. I'm going to have all of you looking at the same network. It's not a race or anything, but this is a complex job that I think will benefit from the group's collective attention. Missions are up. Good luck all. The Hermetic Alchemists. The administrator of a strange philosophical group's server system has developed some software that we will need for future projects. The program we are looking for is an advanced piece of trace diverting software that's been developed in-house. Unfortunately, all we know is that the developer runs the linked network of servers and basically nothing else. We need you to track them down, find their development setup, and secure a build of this software for our future use. Preliminary scans show the network to be quite extensive and to host files and various services for a philosophical group called the Hermetic Alchemists. As this sysadmin seems competent, I'm having everyone investigate this at once, leaving as little time for them to respond as possible. If you discover something that may be useful to the rest of the team, post it in the chat. School of the as above, so below. Proceed. Okay, I need two of you, and I would start with you and you. I see Coagula, Solve, and Rebis. Welcome to Heaven. Solved Coagua. Name of God. What? So I saw Coagua, right? What the hell? I mean, if you say so, I guess. For now, I'm pleased that they're generally rather slow. So my scan is complete, so I can have a look at the system. Tablet Latin, tablet Newton. Once again, name of God, Rebis. What the hell am I looking at? I mean... some stuff. Yeah, so we have a firewall here. Wait, what? No way. And how many lines are there? So far we are going to 5 lines. 6. Seven. That is not cool. Let me put it this way. All that I can say now that it has C and T in it. So it's something like C, don't know, T, something. Why is it said HTTPS? Okay. Yeah, I get it now. heaven, Quagua. Name of God again. Info. What is in this info? Okay. I would expect it to be protected, but it's not the case. Rebbe's firewall pass is Clarity. I found an encrypted file on Solve that you two might be interested in. Decrypted, it seems to say that the password to Rebbe's is Clarity. Doesn't seem to be working for me, for the admin account though. And as usual, as soon as we get access, we do a scan, we do an EOS scan behind the curtain. Oh, I found Nate's e-phone. Rebbe's. That's all very cryptic, you know? Eh? I'll take that one actually. Now we will quickly have a look at Nate's e-phone. Notes. Home. He has home and he has work. 6616558 9. Nate Wesson's home, and we also have 6696149916 is Rebbe's. Calcination. Well, okay, whatever. Fixation. And projection. We also have his account at Gmail, and he's an alchemist, Nate, with the password of manifestation. Thank you. Okay, with that out of the way, we can have a look at the chat. Can anyone remind me the default admin pass? Okay, yeah, I know that. All right, for now, I'd like to wrap it here. This was a nice episode. We finished the main quest. We finished the main part. Supposedly we saved the world from the Hacknet, which is without any shade of a doubt a good thing. We only left the world with the NSEC. Perhaps they will still be able to recover their work though, so it might become a repeating task to fight with the Hacknet, but we'll see how it will go. And now we have switched to Kagwa Trials, and we are participating in some kind of new group. They have fun tools, they have a new way of communication. I like what I see, I enjoy what I'm seeing, I definitely enjoy all those new animations. The Kagwa Trials itself animation was nice, albeit short and very similar to the port tester. I do like the torrent stuff, and I liked that my first immediate thought was also reflected in the chat of those guys. I do enjoy the faster FTP stuff and the more complicated SSL thingy. Ever so slightly more complicated, but still, I enjoy it. And as I was saying, I'd like to wrap it up around here. Thank you for staying with me, I hope you enjoy my company and my gameplay. In such a case, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel, or otherwise let me know down in the comments what I can improve for you. Hope to see you next time, have a nice day out there, and bye!